Hello everyone. I wanted to consider some examples of how you can specify datum features based off assembly and function. So we're going to look at a bunch of parts and we're going to practice applying the datum features based off how they go together. So let's go to our first part. Here we have a piston pin, right? Nice shiny on the outside, pretty dark on the inside. How it works is it simply goes into these two holes right here to hold in, if I can get it in, to hold in something right in the middle. Usually it's called a connecting rod that would go right here. And then this would go up and down in your engine based off this area right here and the alignment of the outer cylinder into the cylinder head. So, given how it goes in, right, that's the center right here. It can't stick out too much up here or down here. And it has to fit in nice and smooth into these two holes. Okay, based off that, what do you think the datum features should be? So the datum features for a part like this would actually be the outer cylindrical surface would most definitely be datum feature A. And when a cylindrical surface is a datum feature, that means its datum is the axis of that cylinder. And datum feature B would be the width of the pin. And by definition of a width being a datum feature, that would denote a center plane as the datum. So the width is the datum feature, the center plane is the datum. The outer cylindrical surface is the datum feature, the axis is the datum. Okay? Because those are the two most crucial pieces of this piston pin. Let's look at the piston now. Should it have some similar datum features? By golly, it does. But because so much importance is on the outer cylindrical surface here going into the bore of the engine, the outer cylindrical surface of this piston is most likely datum feature A, which means that datum A is the axis of this outer cylinder. So datum feature A is the outer cylindrical surface. Datum A is the axis of the outer cylindrical surface. Okay, what would datum feature B be? Most likely, because there's so much pressure on the connection here at this hole, the datum feature B would not just be one of these holes right here, it'd be both, because they're both equally important. So both of them will be called out as datum feature B. And because the datum feature is a cylindrical surface, the datum is an axis. Let's look at something else. So here I have two components of a small engine. Now parts like this are highly complex, so they probably have multiple datum reference frames. So let's just look at one. Let's just look at one thing that's really important for these two parts. Okay. How these go together is their cylindrical surfaces will align. Okay. Their cylindrical surfaces will align and then their two flat faces are going to touch flush. Right. And then bolts will be used to assemble them together. So based off that, what do you think the datum features are? So the datum features are the outer cylindrical surface, right? Potentially the inner cylindrical surface as well, but the outer cylindrical surface is very important here, and the planar face right here. The same thing goes on this part. Definitely part of the datum features are these cylindrical hole right here and the flat face. the flat face, because those are crucial to assembly and going to be crucial to operation. Right? I'm not saying those are the only datum features. I'm saying that those are two possible datum features in the many datum from the many datum features that probably consist on both of these parts. Okay? And if the datum feature is cylindrical, that means the datum is an axis. And if the datum feature is planar, that means the datum is a plane, right? So if we have a cylindrical surface datum feature, the datum is an axis. And if we have a planar surface datum feature, the datum is a plane, okay? So now here's what I want you to do. I want you to consider the index assembly that is pictured in your discussion board. And I want you to look specifically at the blue index plate. Based off this assembly, what do you think the datum features should be? And I'll give you a hint. Datum features usually are not fastener holes. You know where bolts would go through? They're usually not those. Okay? They're more focused on the critical assembly components of parts. So where do you think they are? So you're on the right track if you had a guess of the small outer cylinder of the index plate being a datum feature, this bottom planar face being a datum feature, and this planar face on the right side being a datum feature. Those are the datum features for this part.